Good morning, folks, and I'm glad to see you again on my YouTube video channel about aviation. My name is Andrey Borisevich, and I'm a pilot and corporate pilot, owner of flight school, Sky Eagle Aviation Academy, and I do this video about another airplane. So this aircraft is pretty unique and really popular in the world. I can tell you half of requests about buying aircraft is about this one. So maybe somebody can see familiar instrument panel and you probably know what the airplane is. But this is my first time in this aircraft, and not like in the previous videos when I checked the POH whole night before flight, I know about this aircraft just zero, nothing. I did it for a reason. I didn't open a POH, I didn't check the numbers, I didn't check the performances, I didn't take any information about this aircraft, I didn't read even specification. So I have no ideas about performances and what this aircraft is capable for and what is this about. All these questions I will ask my friend of mine, captain of this aircraft, his name Pavel, and he will fly with me today from Apaloka, Miami to my favorite airport, Everglades, and back. I hope this is nice aircraft, and as I said, I know about this airplane just zero, and I did it for purpose. I would like to fly this airplane first time and share with you my first impression and my first feeling about flying this aircraft. Meet, please, Pilatus PC-12. And GX.
Over the ground when ready to taxi, November 3333 November. Okay, starting up. My side clear.
What are you looking for? You looking for ITT?
Yeah, for sure. For ITT, oil pressure normal, NG rising, good, ITT maximum 680, which is good. And also 64.4, and we are waiting for our RPM, about 1000.
1000 idle, and what is normal RPM? 2500?
No, 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 1700.
Okay.
And in drop low speed, it is 1550. Alright, so engine is stabilized. We need flaps 15 for takeoff, and now air conditioning is working.
Perfect, much
everything
better.
It's working.
Life
yeah.
is good.
Yeah, for sure. Basically,
well, what do you do right
ender,
now?
Ender. Passengers, now we have.
It's weight and balance?
Yeah.
This is what you do?
For the airplane. So we have four people on board, about 150 each, and cargo, let's say, it is 100 lbs.
My operator is 200 pounds at least.
Okay, good. Computing, and now we have a vertical profile for the flight.
Oh, it shows your vertical profile.
Yeah. So today we are going.
How you navigate here? So you navigate by.
It is called cursor control device. This is a cursor like a ball on a mountain.
Mouses,
yeah. So this is like a ball. This is a scrolling device. We can scroll it all over the menu, like here, for example, up and down, and or use the scale. Use it as a scale, so yeah, we can actually increase the scale and locate our airplane right on the map.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so Miami 9, it is vectoring, right?
Let's see departure briefing. I would like to see the departure.
Just give me a second.
Yeah, on the departure procedure, climb to assigned altitude. We have to size 2000 assigned altitude.
Yeah.
Special instructions, turboprops operate in a manner that will result in the best forward speed and climb rate.
Takeoff
minimum standard.
Transition.
It's still
37.
Yeah,
it is
the pusher test.
What information? Ike. No, this is my button.
No. This is push to talk. You see here?
This one?
Yeah.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
She's holding the process. Tango November 1 to runway 9 left. November 33 November. Ready? Parking brake on your side, right?
You push and interrupt switch instead of push to talk.
My control?
You have control, parking brake released. Brake checked.
Ground Cherokee 11 landing.
Cherokee 1122 Alpha Block Ground, welcome. Turn left on November, right on.
Oh, just check taxi diagram for me because I'm not really in. We're going to lay off left and turn right, correct? Yeah, that's what I see. Do we have reverse here?
Mike Alpha,
yes.
Contact.
Do you use reverse on the taxi?
Yeah, for sure.
Berlin.
You have beta range. No, it is.
Alpha,
Lito, we have the limitation, maximum 30 seconds
in
beta range. Yeah, just keep it in mind.
Okay.
We almost did all the checks inside, so we need taxiing external lights.
33 November, hold short of Tango.
Hold short on Tango 3 at November Tango and remain at this frequency, 33 November.
So taxiing checklist, yeah, external lights, taxi lights on, PAX warning switches on. Parking brake handle, release brakes, check, double check, and power control lever. We have and we use idle and reverse and display units. We have heading 309.
And what is the pressure? 3005.
Pressure 3005, correct.
3005, check.
Yeah, before departure, checklist target takeoff torque calculated automatically here.
So I just need to use takeoff or MCP on a takeoff. To Toga?
No. Ah, you, yeah, we
Toga,
use
right?
Takeoff thrust.
Takeoff thrust. Okay.
And if you want, you can use auto throttle system, which is installed here, digital auto throttle.
Okay.
So we can utilize
this and
it will be
everything. How much taxi you need?
It will be automatic.
It shouldn't be more than maybe 5 or 10 minutes left.
You'll
you
want
to
check how it's balanced.
And taxi be a
pop-up.
No, this is Tango 3 on the left side.
Hold short of Tango on Echo.
Confirm.
Going to get C2's first
drop.
3-3 November, continue taxi and contact tower. Thank you.
And Echo Alpha,
can you switch
to
Echo, please?
Yeah, we're ready to go. It's about 7 with Mike. Taxi to run up.
Opa-loka tower, 123-675.
And let's talk about speed. We rotate V1 and climb speed.
We rotate here is 82 knots, always, almost always.
82?
Yeah,
I see the plane. We ready for departure?
Yeah.
So 82 knots, right?
Yeah.
Okay, 82 knots rotate and climb speed?
And climb speed will be up to 140.
Up to 140.
Yeah.
And the flaps up speed?
Flaps up here is... I will explain it a little bit later.
Okay.
Just keep the dynamic speed bug.
Gotcha. November 3333 November on 9 or left, wait for takeoff, flight heading 090.
Do you want to use the auto throttle?
Tower 401, I got a traffic inside helicopter.
Yeah, anyway, we're gonna go to Toga, right?
401, Roger, turn right northbound.
Yeah, Toga, slowly.
And then go to MCP,
yeah.
Right? Okay.
9 left, November 121,
taking off.
Power set, airspeed alive.
Okay.
If you run,
rate on go.
72
023 Romeo, taxi via Golf, hold short runway 12 at Golf.
Positive rate,
yep.
Brakes.
Taxi via Golf, hold short 12 via Golf, 23 Romeo
and your
damper
off.
Thank you.
Don't use your pedals.
Okay.
Okay, speed above 100 knots, flaps.
Flaps up, please.
42 Sierra Echo, runway 9
left. I'm going back to MCP.
MCP?
Yeah,
you can. 33 November, contact Miami Departure, good day.
Miami Departure, 33 November, thank you. Miami Departure, November 33 November, on the heading 090, passing 1300.
Now you can see here from the left side, this is called dynamic speed fog. This is 1.3 of your stall speed in any configuration. It is just depends on angle of the angle only. This is the unique, flight directors, which is flight path vector. Okay. This is an acceleration chevron, which means basically it shows us the energy of the airplane. If it is higher, so the energy is high, right? So we will accelerate or climb or...
November, niner, November, contact Miami approved.
Yeah, accelerating. If you decrease the power...
25.5, have a good one, 99 November.
Yeah, you can see...
November 60, Charlie, turn left heading 270.
Acceleration chevron will be...
270,
I'm going down to the
will be decelerated as...
This is trim on my right hand.
Yeah, yeah, you, to use the trim you need... Yeah, simultaneously.
Let's see what's going on.
It is very sensitive.
So, we are not a thrust, so I can push down the thrust.
Yeah, you can. We need to...
Get 343, 343, maintain 100 knots, so final contact
it is
with left tower 134.67.
Auto throttle.
November 303, November turn left at 360.
Left, heading 360, November. Heading 360, please.
Left heading 360, set, auto throttle on, and I set the speed 170 knot. And now auto throttle is engaged, and auto throttle is maintaining, will be maintaining now, speed 170 knots.
I gotcha.
And we overfly the
340. Okay, yeah. So 340.
Yeah, 340. Do we need autopilot?
Let me fly.
November 60 Charlie, traffic 1 o'clock, 2 miles.
Trying to figure out how to use this team because looks like it's... I don't use to get it.
You see? Let me check.
Yeah, I'm working on the Fort Lauderdale International on the right side.
Good afternoon, 998 Charlie, thank you.
Yeah, so you're pressing the key
climbing,
and simultaneously use up, down, left, right. You don't need left, right, so up, down, that's
what I need. I just need to get to
So the auto throttle now is maintaining 170.
Oh, everything is good.
Yeah.
Life is good. If you put 190, it will maintain 190, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can easily.
Yeah, let's go to 190. We'll see how it works.
Yeah, 190 set.
Checked. And I see the engine
increasing.
Parameters is increasing right now.
So 55 Papa momentum. And 2 Alpha Romeo will maintain 170 knots until a 5-mile final contact is exhausted.
I don't understand this green indication. What it shows me, my flight path, right?
You see? Yeah.
And what is this green one?
The green one is the difference between your actual speed and the required speed, which is set to auto throttle, by auto throttle or something.
Where is my flight director stand?
This is your primary flight director.
The green one?
Yeah. You see, for example, we are flying in heading select mode. So if I choose several degrees to the right, let's say, you can see that your flight director, your magenta flight director, magenta.
So green plane, this is me, and magenta is my flight director.
Yes.
Now it's easy.
Green, it is your flight path.
Yep.
This is your wings.
Gotcha.
This is your actual...
I mean, all I need to do is just line up the green line with magenta line.
That's right.
So after takeoff checklist completed, all clear?
Yeah, everything
here is up, everything is good.
Outside of all the class dot airspaces.
Climbing 10-6000, 33 November, thank you. So, it will maintain the same airspeed, 190, right?
Yeah.
And I will start climbing and the power will increase. Okay, I see what's going on.
The power will increase up to maximum continuous thrust, maximum continuous power, and it will be maintaining 190.
Perfect. And at this point, we have about 1300 feet per minute, right?
Yeah.
What is your max climb performance when you empty, for example? Like 2000 feet per minute? Should be on top of the left, right?
Yeah, activated.
Okay.
And NAV mode.
Got you. Thank you.
No, just follow your flight directors.
I see. Okay, we pass in 4200 and turn director shock.
Yep. We can decrease our speed.
50 November, do you have taken your flight plan?
Yeah, back pressure. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's good.
So I can pitch up about like 7 to 8 degrees pitch. Okay, I see. And I have 97% of power right now.
Yeah. 1000 to level off.
800 to go, 600 to go. Indication is pretty good. I'm just getting used to Garmin always.
Miami, good afternoon. November 470, uh-huh. Delta Charlie.
What is this avionic? What's the name of this avionic? It's something different, right?
Yes, it is. Honeywell Primus Apex.
Left turn, heading 270, climb lane 10, 10,000, jump blue 14.
It's 6,000.
Yeah, the
weather radar.
Clouds.
What do we see?
You managed speed because speed is decreasing to 170.
Yeah, yeah. I said, look, the auto throttle now is in manual mode.
Okay.
In manual mode and in manual speed mode.
Which means?
So, yeah. So we will maintain 170 knots. Why 170?
Because clouds and turbulence penetration.
Yeah.
I see. So we have turn right right now.
Turning right, correct.
You manage speed by back, right? So you have manage speed back here?
Yeah, so this is for heading.
Okay.
This for auto throttle, for
and
our
for
speed. This for altitude, that's right.
And this is for approach.
No, this one for approach.
Tuesday, November, contact Palm Beach approach on 125.2, good day.
Okay, let's go direct to destination.
Palm Beach, Executive 6, sir. Want to Papa Roger, maintain VFR.
Can you check, please, wind conditions and weather in destination?
Services provided.
We will pick what road we're going to use, 1-3-3-1.
VFR, November 211 at the top.
We checked before on the ground, so the runway use was 1-3.
1-3.
7-6-9-6, Fox, Palm Beach, how do you hear?
Where I can clock see VFR, distance to destination.
Here.
40 miles, right?
Here.
40 miles and 2. Okay.
Yeah, this is, well, but actually here, this distance to go,
okay.
ETE.
12 minutes.
Yeah, 12 minutes and fuel remaining at our destination.
Number 7, this should be faster
here
for you.
Is a touch screen controller. So it is also unique function to Pilatus PC-12NGX. So the letter X. It's about this one and digital auto throttle. So, see here is some direct to in images, some buttons about weather radar communication. We can set the frequencies here and swap it here in this window. Also, navigation frequency, transponder, and so on. So it is very useful thing, very
easy to use.
Easy to use, yeah. Comparing to the old one.
Okay.
November 33 November. Contact Miami Center 132.45. Take care.
3245 Miami Center 33 November.
Bobby Roach 125.2.
3245. Is
5.2.
If it is well trimmed, Merck said it's 1.0.250.
It's 10-250, extension 78.
Miami Center 33 November 6000.
This
is my
beach. It's
like
the
beach, right?
Your
position, left position, beam settings, my electrical system, fuel panel, environment. So this is all about my status of aircraft, right?
Yeah,
right.
It's not much.
So you just call it if you need to change something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. These are not touch screens, but this is one touch screen.
11.8, 32.07.
Thank you, Delta 1321, yeah.
The pilot. Left line and right line. You need to change something.
Yeah, these lines called gazelle buttons. though they have several multi-functions, like, for example, center the airplane, so you can set escape waypoints, center back, north up. It is, everything is different.
Soft buttons.
Yeah, yeah, soft buttons.
Never seen Delta Charlie for traffic, but...
It depends on what has it signed.
So disregard. Just remain in the departure. You do have traffic at 10 o'clock and 10 miles north on a flight of...
With these cell buttons, you can swap the frequencies.
Here, Delta Charlie, copy.
You see? Yep. You can manage all your...
Yes, sir, traffic at 9 o'clock, 10 miles north on a flight of 6 speaker.
This panel is about this one?
Which is reminder not to forget, in 1 minute
Miami,
to start our
descent,
at the same altitude selection,
so
we can descend whatever we need.
Level 237 Mike Delta, I will have it amended to your reading advisory to copy.
1007, press, enough.
Get right back to you.
Now?
Executive 697,
the airplane will descend by itself.
Executive 697, I'm sorry, clear bongos. 697, clear bongos.
The bongos,
Number 3, Juliet, contact Miami Center 127.2.
37.23,
White Cab 330 traffic, 2 to 3 o'clock, 2 miles southeast mountain, altitude gate 1,100.
Did you start your descent?
Changed frequency, changed.
Gotcha. We will descend and power to idle radio.
Auto throttle off.
And you don't have any speed brakes here, right?
No.
No, you don't have speed brakes. I see.
We have landing gear.
Okay. What is the max max speed for landing gear?
180. You see G?
Gotcha.
Depends for gear.
That's fine.
By default, here is the right traffic button.
Yep.
So I tune up everything for visual approach.
Perfect.
Visual approach for runway 13.
I don't see runway.
Yeah, you can see it. You can see it here.
That's
here. It is. No.
No.
Here is the runway. Here.
Oh, I see.
And you can see it.
There. Yeah, I see it visually, but I don't see. I mean, I see. Oh, yeah, the runway inside. We're on a frequency already?
Yeah, on a frequency, right.
Airplane traffic, Pilatus descending from 3000 to better altitude. We will join to right downwind for runway 134 full stop landing.
Okay, he is on the right base. I see. One to go. And now I have manual control on the throttle, right?
Yeah.
What is the max altitude for this aircraft? What do you usually fly? 280?
Maximum is flight level 300. RVSM approved and let's say, basically we are flying 270 something.
And pressurization cabin climb, when you have pressurized cabin, the cabin will stay at 5,000 feet or?
Or about 6,000.
6,000.
It is 6,000.
Okay, one more question. Approach speed?
Approach speed will be, for this condition, about 115.
Okay,
yeah.
Roger. Okay,
Clear traffic, Pilatus join left, right downwind for runway 13, it will be full stop, near clear. Okay, I can do flaps 15?
Yes.
Okay.
That's right. No.
Push. Oh, I see. Flaps 15. Now we're good on a gear. Gear down.
Gear down.
Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 3 green. Yep. Okay, before landing, checklist, please.
Traffic, white sky, clear, runway 13, taxi vector 13, via
landing gear, 3 green lights.
Check.
Flaps. We'll
land 30 or 40?
40.
40? Okay.
We have pressurization below 0.7. Good. And speed, dynamic speed bug. I need to...
This one?
Yeah.
So I need to chase the green. Okay.
Yeah. You check.
Yeah, flaps 30. That shows me 90, but you said 115 is approach speed.
Because previously it was 100 knots.
Okay.
The dynamic speed bug was on 100 knots, but you can use your flaps 40.
Yep. This is a plan.
Airway traffic, Pilatus on the final runway 13, full stop lane.
I will chase about 90 knots, right?
Yeah.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Now where's?
Right.
Uh-huh. Radio idle. Do you like my leaning? Nice and easy.
The ailerons, as you see, coupled with your...
Rudder?
Yeah, rudder.
Okay.
That's right. So, if you press left, so the rudder will be
there,
and the ailerons.
I see. Park and brake.
Parking brake set, pedals pressed. And waiting 2 minutes.
We wait for 2 minutes after leaning to cool down the engine. And as soon as 2 minutes expire or ended, we will shut down and we will do the flow for shut down the engine. 1 minute more, or actually 45 seconds more, I see. So during these 2 minutes, no any action. You don't need to do something or, okay. No need nav. This is taxi light. We don't need taxi light. We don't need smoking. We don't need seat belts. Everything else is good. And this is the same button for start and for off, right? No? Or you shut down by some other procedure?
We shut down like pulling this and shut it down.
Oh, okay.
Move it to off.
Gotcha.
And now we will use feather inhibit. Not to damage the propeller. So, holding feather inhibit. Just shut down. You see, drive motoring and prop feather inhibit.
Nice.
Yep. EPS.
What is EPS? It's electric electronical power system.
Emergency
power system.
That's it.
Thank you so much. My first ride on the Pilatus. I love it. I love it.
Awesome.
At least I know how to open the door. This is the most important for corporate pilot and for pilots for private usage. Guys, I really enjoyed to fly this airplane. It was my first takeoff and first landing on Pilatus PC-12, and I was really happy to fly PC-12NGX. So what I can tell you, my first impressions and my first feeling about flying this aircraft, easy. So I would say it's like easy to fly this airplane. I flew about like 25-30 minutes manually without any autopilot, and the reason for that, because I would like to feel the airplane. I'd like to feel the nature of this aircraft, how it's fly, how it's controllable, how it's stable, how it's manageable. And I would say all parameters and all my expectation is completely satisfied. So airplane is flying really, really well. And as a pilot who's flying most of the time single engine piston aircraft, like Cessna 172, I didn't have any problem to transition from small plane to PC-12 because I also flew jet before, Learjet 60. And for me, it was absolutely fine, natural, simple, easy, as I said. So I love to fly Pilatus. And it's really good avionic package and it's full autopilot, auto throttle. As I realized from the captain, NGX model, they have FedEx. I'll show you FedEx right here. And this aircraft has auto throttle. So you don't need to worry about power settings most of the time during your flight. So I enjoy it. I love it. Let's walk around and let's see what this airplane has to show from outside. So let's start walk around of this aircraft from the door. As you see, it's a standard handle. You just need to open the handle and door will fall down on you. Pretty simple. Door is combined with steps. So it's really easy to open and close the door. I don't want to spend more time on this because it's pretty simple. We need to be careful with these lines as usually. They always need to be inside. When you close the door, that's it. So this light is anti-ice light. It will show you if you have any ice on the leading edge of the wing. And FedEx. Do you remember I told you this aircraft NGX has FedEx? This is actually the unit which is responsible for the FedEx. And this unit is provided by Pratt & Whitney, PT6 engine manufacturer, all together with the engine. So this is the difference between Pilatus PC-12NG and NGX. NGX has FedEx, and FedEx allows you to use auto throttle, so which is really nice. And it works pretty well. So when you're flying in a cruise mode, you just need to set desired airspeed and FedEx will maintain power settings to give you this desired airspeed. Even if you're in a climb mode, for example. On a descent, it's a little bit more complicated because this aircraft doesn't have speed brakes. So without speed brakes, you need to go full idle and try to use gear or flaps to slow down. So this is about FedEx. The engine itself is a PT667XP, 1200 horsepower. Let's see, where is the engine? I guess it's here. Look at this. I don't want to use it, actually. I'll just hold it. So it's dual generators, two generators here, one and two, and everything else is pretty standard. I'm not sure what else I can tell you about the engine because it's just normal turbine engine, PT667XP, just normal PT6. All I can see is oil level check, it's right here, and everything else is pretty simple. So technically, as a pilot, I don't need to know anything else about this engine. What I need to know, therefore, I need to know about this area. As you can see, it's very hot area, do not touch. So this is sleep. So this sleep always heated from exhaust system and it's always, always really hot. So for pilots or passengers or just people who would like to know something about aircraft, just be careful. Avoid touching this area because this can be really dangerous. Five blade prop. This leading edge of the prop is heatable, so it's electrical heat here. This is part of anti-ice system, or anti-ice system. Steerable nose wheel, as on every big airplane, turbine airplane, jet airplane, it's always steerable. What else? On the left side, I can see here oxygen bottle, and it's a green circle. The green circle shows me the oxygen is on. This is oxygen serviceable point, and I can see oxygen pressure. 1200 psi. This is oxygen bottle. But this one is really interesting. This hole is an outflow valve for pressurization system. So I see this valve is open right now because we are on the ground. On the ground, we unpressurized. Let's move on the right wing. So this is leading edge, and as you can see, it's equipped with de-icing boots. So de-icing boots is a part of the icing system, and pilot can engage the system when it's icing conditions outside. Everything is standard. I don't see something special here. Simple as is. So this is fuel tank for jet AL fuel. We will check the capacity later on. Standard pita tube, and this is really interesting feature. Actually, to be honest, I see this device first time. This is angle of attack. So I can understand this is angle of attack by this wing, but the place where angle of attack is located is pretty interesting, on the leading edge of left wing and right wing. So this bulb, I believe everybody knows what is this, but if you don't know or you're just guessing, put this below in the comments. I'll let you know later on what is this bulb about. So everything else is pretty simple. Oh, I see PC-12NGX, you know? Now I know what airplane we're taking videos about. Ailerons, as I can see, the surface and the square of this aileron is not so big, but the airplane is really good controllable, which I was really surprised about the flaps. The flaps is really long line, so it looks like the length of these flaps is huge. And these flaps has three positions, actually four. Zero flaps, 15 degrees flaps, 30 degrees flaps, and full flaps, which is 40 degrees. Look at the bottom of the fuselage. Actually, flaps is going all the way down to here. And well, when all flaps is down, full flaps, it's a lot of drag and it's huge surface. The reason for that, it's unpaved runways. Because PC-12 certified to land not only on the paved runways or like concrete or asphalt, but also to the grass, gravel, and unpaved runways. And actually, landing roll on this aircraft is really short, about 2,500 feet. When I land this airplane here in Everglades, I used full reverse and we stopped right away. really fast, so it's going to slow down pretty good. As usually, static port, delta fins for stability, de-icing boots on the stabilizer rudder, and now we are approaching to the most interesting part of this aircraft. I believe everybody knows about that. All owners and all operators love it because this is huge cargo door. Let's see what is this. Woo-hoo. This door is amazing. So you can put inside whatever you want. For example, a refrigerator, freeze. I don't know, motorcycle, bicycles, I don't know what else, boxes, boat, engine for the boat, two engines for the boats, I don't know, big family. So on my way back, when we're gonna fly back to Miami, we will do video from inside the fuselage and the cabin. But I know for sure this seat is removable, so you can just easily remove this seat. You can easily remove rear seat, and you will have all this huge compartment for baggage or whatever you need, I don't know. Friend of mine who is owner of this aircraft, he usually lie on the floor, on the rear, and he usually sleep during the flight. So you can do the same. And this huge baggage compartment here, I don't wanna go deep inside because it's like personal belongings here, but you need to know from here up to here it's also baggage compartment. So you can put a lot of baggages here. Let me see. Now, up to here. This is the Hermit pressurized cabin. So you can put a lot of luggage on the back, a lot of boxes here, whatever you want. I don't know, bullets, refrigerators, motorcycles, and you're good to go. So this aircraft is really good for travelers. If you would like to travel in Africa, Latin America, I don't know, Canada, if you would like to travel in remote lands, islands, or something like that, you can take all of your life and put it with you in the cabin. I love it. Ooh-hoo. I did it. Done. So as I said, this is really good airplane for travelers. You ask me about the price, and unfortunately, I know the price. And from my personal opinion, it's a little bit higher than my expectation. It's overpriced. I know this aircraft was delivered in May 2022 for 5.7, but now I guess it's a little bit more than $6 million. I know people who is really want to buy Pilatus because the order line, the backlog is about like 14, 18 months. If you put the order today, you will have your aircraft in 2024, maybe in March or May 2024. Now is December 2022, so more than 1 year is a waiting time. So if you would like to buy aircraft which was delivered and just produced and delivered to the owner, and owner decided to sell this aircraft for you, to you, it will be about like $6.5-7 million. This is what I heard from the market price. This particular plane was 5.7, I don't remember, 5.5, 5.7, something like that. And friend of mine who is owner of this airplane, he ordered it in 2020 and he waited about more than 1 year. This is the backside of the coin, but despite the price, everything else about this aircraft is perfect. Oh, not really everything. Give me 1 second. What I remember from pilot in command of this aircraft, the captain, he told me approximately max cruise speed he usually uses on this aircraft is 260 knots. In my personal opinion, this is slow. For 6 million aircraft flying on the flight level 260, 270, 280, 260 knots, it's not good. Actually, even HondaJet can fly faster, and VisionJet can fly faster. And if you compare HondaJet and Pilatus, for example, it's the same price, 5.5, 5.7 million, but HondaJet can fly up to flight level 430 on a speed more than 340, 350 knots, true speed, or I don't remember, 0.67 Mach, as I remember. And even VisionJet is faster. So another negative side about the Pilatus, from my personal view, it's airspeed. Airspeed is not really good, but everything else is fine. And one engine, but again, PT6 engine is pretty trusted engines. They don't have much problems. And even if you fly on a single engine aircraft, single pilot over the water or ocean or whatever, it's not a big problem for you, is my personal opinion. But again, if you live on islands and you would like to fly over the islands, maybe two-engine airplane is better. So here of my video today is Pilatus PC-12NGX. And continue to watch this video. We will show you inside the airplane from the passenger point of view. Stay tuned, subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions about aircraft, put it in the comments below this video. Guys, it's me again. My name is Andrey Borisevich and I'm flying right now Pilatus PC-12NGX as a passenger. So we about to take off from Air Glades Airport here in Florida, and we are holding short right now from runway 13. And the reason why I'm trying to show you this aircraft from inside, from the passenger side of view, because I have a lot of requests from my customers who is interested to be an owner of Pilatus PC-12, who would like to buy this aircraft to fly for private pleasure or business purposes. Now, as you can see, the main feature of this aircraft is really quiet. So we don't have any headsets right now. I just have my microphone on me, and all this background noise and all this sound around, this is natural. So we don't have any filters or noise reduction or anything else. So I asked my cameraman to show takeoff specifically, because takeoff, it's a stage of flight when engine is running on the highest possible RPM. So, and this is the most powerful part of the flight, and I would like to see how noisy it will be in the cabin, or it will be okay. So let's see. I see pilots is about taking off from runway 13 right now, and I feel like I'm in a soccer commentator on a play, on a game, explaining them what's going on. So engine is going to high RPM right now. Looks like it's a full power. It's okay. So I don't hear really bad sound or too loud, too noisy. That's great. As Oleg said 5 minutes ago, looks like Pilatus PC-12 is quieter than HondaJet we flew last year. Yeah, let's see. It's good. So now we can play with all these buttons and seats and tables and all this stuff. So what I can see here is really nice cabin. So it's 2022 aircraft, and let's see what I can do in a cabin as a passenger. So always after takeoff, I would like to relax a little bit. I would like to see how far his rear back seat can go. Ooh, holy shit. I can actually lie down here, so. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. This is all I need. This is great. No, it's not all I need. I need this one also. Here we go. Can you ask pilot in command captain to fly to Las Vegas? Or Bahamas? Or Cuba? Let's go to Cuba. Laptop will fit on this table on a Pilatus PC-12. I need to move closer. That's good. I mean, it's good enough. What I actually like on this chair, I can move this chair 45 degrees out. What I need. Big table, enough space for laptop, enough space for beverages, enough space for snacks. I feel comfortable. Looks good to me. And it's a lot of space here. Of course, you cannot stay an aisle, but I will see. Let me check how it looks like. Control, and one more time, like it. I really like it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 seats. So it's really comfortable for 6 people. And you're absolutely right, it's quieter than HondaJet, and it's more comfortable than HondaJet. I'm really surprised it is. It's more comfortable for passengers. Let's go to check the restroom. Pilatus PC-12, one of the aircraft with in light category, I mean light turboprop category with restroom. So it's really a nice invention, to be honest, because what Pilatus does with toilet. First of all, you have two doors. Door number one will lock you, your cabin, from pilot side, from the pilot cockpit. The second door is this one, will lock you from the cabin. And finally, you can close this piece, and you are in a house. Now you can use restroom and nobody will bother you, and you will not bother anybody else. So this is really cool. Done. We're approaching to Miami Apolloca Airport. What I can tell you about as a conclusion about this aircraft itself. I really like this aircraft as a pilot, but most of that I like this aircraft as a passenger. I think this Pilatus PC-12 is one of the best plane, especially in the turboprop category, and between light jets and middle-sized jets and turboprops, one of the best planes I ever flew as a passenger from different points of view. First of all, it's a 6-seat airplane, not 4, not 3, it's a full 6-seat aircraft. And this aircraft is comfortable and have enough room, a lot of room for 6 people. All these chairs, flexible, comfortable. You can sleep during the flight, which is really important. You can work during the flight, which is also really important. You can do whatever you need during your business trip or flight for pleasure. I can personally take all of my family here. I have 5 people, 3 kids, kids on the back, me and my wife, and I can take actually one more friend with me. And it's huge baggage compartment, as you can see. We can take a lot of baggage in a baggage compartment. I can put skis or snowboard here in an aisle and fly to Colorado to ski, for example. This is restroom is right here, really nice designed and invented. And as a pilot, I can fly this aircraft without type rating, which is really nice because this aircraft is below 12,500 pounds. So I can easily fly this airplane by myself without additional type rating. I know all insurance companies, they require some special training for Pilatus, but technically by FAA law, I can fly this aircraft without type rating, which I already did on the right seat, as you can see. And what else? Pilatus, well known and famous as an aircraft, carry on a lot of cargo and passengers and useful load. And this is true actually, because as I said, you can take full tanks, you can take 4 or 5 passengers on board, and you can fly up to 1800 miles. This is the max range for this aircraft with 3-4 passengers. I already discussed these performances, but one more time, which only one parameter I don't really like in this aircraft is airspeed, because cruise speed around 260 to 70, and a cruise flight level 270 to 80. I didn't check consumption rate, but I can imagine if it's a PT6 engine, 67, PT6, 67, I guess consumption rate will be around 80, 90 gallons an hour. So the aircraft can stay in the air up to 6 hours easily. And that's it. This is all you need to know about Pilatus PC-12. In my personal opinion, if this plane cost not $5.76 million, but $3 million, I would buy it. And I believe it, a lot of people would buy this aircraft for $3 million. But unfortunately, the price for this aircraft is $5.7 and $6.5 million as for now, for December 2022. Maybe at the time when you will see this video, the price will increase again, and it will be more and more and more expensive. So we're about at 3,000 feet right now, approaching to Miami Apaloca Airport, about 15 miles out. I can see Everglades and Miami already. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel, please, if you would like to see more videos about aircraft and aviation life. My video blog is about aircraft flight review, manufacturer, pilots, events, and everything what can be related to aviation world, including education and pilot education. My name is Andrey Borisevich, and I'm owner of Sky Eagle Aviation Academy, as well as owner and CEO of Flight Dreams Aircraft Group. This company helps people to buy and sell aircraft. I do sell for the last 6 years. I sold a couple of dozens of aircraft, including turboprops like King Gears, Pilatuses, Pipers, Cheyenne. I sold a couple of jets, and I specialize in helicopters also. So keep in touch, subscribe to my channel. If you need aircraft, call me. If you would like to sell aircraft, call me, I'll try to help you. And don't forget about the following and subscribe for notification, because it helps you to not miss new videos. Stay tuned, thank you very much, bye.